Well, next thing I knew, we were on the American airliner heading for the United States. And right away, I saw a huge difference between the Russian airplanes and the American airplanes. On the Russian airplanes, restrooms outside. And this plane was so luxurious, they're showing a movie on the airplane. And something was funny in the movie. I started laughing. My laughter is a little different than American people laugh. Like, in Russia, we were not allowed to laugh out, so we would laugh in. And it sounded real obnoxious, like, So I started laughing, and the oxygen mask came down. Then I walked in the bathroom on the plane, and by the toilet, there's a sign that says, no foreign objects allowed. 12-hour flight. It wasn't funny then, I'll tell you that. So we landed in Kennedy Airport. Oh, we were on American soil. We were so excited. We were going for the immigration office. And they gave us an interpreter. And for the interpreter, they asked me, what do you want to do in America? I said, I'd like to do comedy. I got one of the biggest laughs I ever had. Those guys were bending over laughing. I said, it's pretty easy over here. And then I see dogs are sniffing my luggage. And I said to the interpreter, what are they doing? And he said, they're looking for drugs. I said, wow. I heard in America, people are hooked on drugs. But dogs? And they started laughing again. I said, I'm doing pretty good so far. Well, you can imagine everything was so confusing. You know, like the word yep, for example. Yep in English means yes. In Russian means to be intimate. I'm not making this up. We're walking from the airport, and my parents hear people say, yep. My dad smiled at my mom. My mom said, nope. So here we are from Kennedy Airport. We go straight to Times Square. And it was so exciting. All of those bright lights and tall buildings and hundreds of cars and thousands of people. In the middle of all of this, I see my name written, big letters. America loves Smirnoff. And I said to myself, what a country, all right. Well, I was determined to learn the language right away. So I locked myself in the room and I was watching TV for 3 days straight. And then I realized it was a Spanish station. And even if I learned the word, I would not necessarily understand the meanings of those words. Like, for example, I saw the ad in the paper that says, big sale last week. I'm going, why advertise? I already missed it. They're just rubbing it in. One ad said, learn to play guitar, no strings attached. One ad scared me. It said, we guarantee our furniture and we stand behind it for 6 months. That's why I left Russia. You know, little things, tiny things that Americans do daily was a big challenge for us. Like, for example, walking in the restaurant and the waitress said, I recommend breakfast special. It's steak and eggs. I said, fine. She said, how do you like your steak? I said, you didn't even bring it yet. Yeah, I bet you never thought of it that way, huh? And then she said, you want buffalo wings? I'm thinking, no wonder buffaloes don't fly. And then I look at the menu and I said, I want a quickie. She poured ice water on my lap. And the guy who was sitting at the table next to me said, I think you want to pronounce it quiche. First time I walked into a fast food place, yeah, in the bathroom, there's a sign that says, baby changing station. So I'm thinking, if you don't like your baby, you get a new one right here. And you get French fries to go with that. In the supermarket, I walked in and I see this carton that says powdered milk. And I'm thinking, what cow does that? And then on the box it says, add water and you get milk. So I'm thinking, well, that's pretty clever. Then I saw powdered orange juice. You add water and you get orange juice. Then I saw baby powder. I'm thinking, I'm making my family tonight. And I bought this scented toilet paper. When do you suppose to smell that? I did it wrong for a long time. Lysol says kills odors. Took me 3 weeks to get rid of the rash from under my eye. That product, Nair, it said get Nair for your hair. 7 weeks to grow it back. This guy is still using it, right? So there you go. Or those diapers that you only change once a week. You've seen them when the package says, holds up to 18 pounds. So what do you do when the diaper weighs more than a baby? You gotta take them to the baby changing station, right?